In a way, slow motion movies started at Stanford. Before there was a Stanford University, this was a farm owned by Leland Stanford. He wanted to find out how racehorses run. So he hired a pioneer photographer, Edward Muybridge, to set up a string of cameras along a racetrack that had shutters that were triggered by the passage of the horse, and that made the first slow motion movie. Stanford is really at the Edward Muybridge stage in molecular movies. We had this wonderful fortune of having one of the world's premier linear accelerators for electrons located on our campus, and it's been turned into an X-ray laser. And the free electron laser is a billion times brighter than the next brightest source of X-rays that scientists have invented to use in the laboratory. And so that was really the key that allowed us to get into the business of making molecular movies once we had a tool like this.
At PULSE Institute, I'm studying one of the most dynamic biological systems. We're trying to understand how ribosome recognizes the genetic code and deciphers it into a new language, a protein language. It has so many moving parts inside, and our goal is to understand how those conformational changes and dynamics are translated into its functions. So here we're trying to image biology while it's still alive.
We can start using these techniques to probe physical processes that were only seen indirectly before. For example, the transport of heat across very small length scales, atomic length scales, it's something that if we get movies of this motion, we can actually start using this to design materials to better control the flow of heat, or materials for batteries, for example. Knowing how the charges, the ions in these batteries move, is tremendous microscopic information.
These movies of atomic motion are also really interesting for a chemist. In our lab, we're interested in understanding how the atoms and the electrons move after a molecule absorbs light. So when a molecule absorbs light, its electrons are rearranged into a higher energy configuration or excited state. And what we want to do is then measure that electronic configuration and also the modes of atomic motion and understand how these two properties are related to each other and also how they dictate the reactivity of the molecule.
Just like the GPU is working in your computer, it's looking at every pixel in the frame in a separate manner and actually rendering them in parallel. We're able to do the same thing with the electronic Schrodinger equation. We're able to take the individual atoms and the individual electrons and look at them separately in parallel on the GPU. And as such, we're able to stitch together a lot of these frames very quickly to actually build up a full molecular movie of the true dynamics of the system.
So these movies should really tell us about how electrons move. And right now we can get to pulses that are around 100 attoseconds in time. The easiest way to understand the attosecond timescale is to look at light. So we can look at the speed of light in one set of units is 186,000 miles per second. So this means to go from Earth to the moon, light takes about 1.3 seconds. Now, a molecular bond is around 1.5 angstroms. The speed of light measured in that unit would be 3 angstroms per attosecond. So this means that instead of taking 1.3 seconds to get to the moon to travel across an atomic bond, light takes about half an attosecond. And so this is kind of the state of the art as to what we can do.
This is a very exciting place to work. And it's because so many people from different fields come together, particularly graduate students and young scientists.
This creates a very unique environment that is very fertile to produce ideas about how to use the X-ray laser to solve different problems across these disciplines.
There's a multiplication effect in the speed and also the power of all of these researchers working in the same problem. It's the power of collaboration.
We are at the beginning, at the early stages of this field, and what we have seen so far has been incredible, and I can barely imagine what's possible in the future.